Hi, hello and welcome to Leaning Towards Six Sigma. Thank you for your continued support. In the Consulting Principle vlog series, this is part 4. There are three parts I have dealt with, three different topics, and I have given the respective links in the YouTube description of this video. Please check that video as well. And in this video, what I'm going to deal with are the words. Words are very powerful, and it can make or break people. Just greeting someone, "Hey, you look great today," just say that, and look at his face, a wonderful face, because the words you have chosen and used it, and the way you have expressed it, that's very important, even in professional life, especially when you deal with the customer. That's what this blog is all about. Before I'm going to discuss about the components of this particular blog, please watch a wonderful video about the words and its impact. Let's watch the video together. Video, isn't it? How word hurts or it creates a positive impact. Same goes here in a professional context as well. Let's look at the categories to start with. The first category, in a professional context, how you deal with the customer communication. First category of words grouped as it lacks humanity. So for example, when I say lacks empathy, in the sense, when a customer complains, I say, "No, this is not our policy," or, "As per our policy, this is not acceptable." If I say that, obviously it lacks empathy and the humanity. That's a category. There are words which come under humanity. Diminished customer. Diminished customer means, example, "I guess you are upset. I guess you are not happy with. I guess you had a bad experience," which means what? I guess, or it seems, if you say these words, which means it's yours, I guess, which I have not understood as a customer service executive. It's what you are saying, which means I don't share your feeling or perception or the emotion, which is dismissive in by nature. That's second category. Third category of words, simple arguments. An argument means you have misunderstood, you made a mistake, you didn't understand, you didn't provide this document. If a customer service executive tells the customer, then those words are argumentative by nature. So these are the categories in a professional communication should be avoided. Let's look at what are those words to be avoided. Customer communication don'ts. Let's look at from the report what the report talks about with my personal experience. The first one is our policy. If I use our, if I use this particular word, our company, our process, our service is something like this, and you are complaining, or this is, which means you are creating a distance between customer and you. So when you use this "our," it is not that personal touch, is what the report says. I also agree. The moment you use ours, our policy or our process, naturally you are alienating the customer, you are not including him. Second will be company policy. This is our company policy. As per the policy, if you say "gone," which means you are not going to hear him, which means according to the policy we have done and you are dissatisfied. How can that be? So the whole point is, don't use policy, etc. That will definitely go against the company. Third, as per our records, which again, all these our policy are, when you use as per our records, all these are saying that we and you, so which is not helping the organization, and customer will never be happy. These are the words to be avoided. Let's look at division. This primarily happens in every company. Customer service department has got nothing to do with the main value chain delivery process or a department. They say, "Okay, let me share this information or communicate with the other department. Our department is different, so you just share your problem. Let's look at it." customer doesn't care about it, because he, what he sees or perceives is one organization. He doesn't care about your department, division, silos. So please don't use your division or your department or somebody else's department. Customer perception. So here what you do is, it's about, when I phrase a statement, it seems you are unhappy, it seems you had a bad experience. You can't use that. The moment you say it seems yours, which means it's your experience, and you dismiss that. It's not about us. It's not about our whole organization and you including. So it seems means you are alienating the customer. And finally, the blame game. You have misunderstood. I'm so sorry, sir, that you have misunderstood the process, or you have misunderstood the documents to submit. Gone. Which means you are blaming the customer. It's no more your process delivering the customer value. Rather, customer has to understand to get the value delivered, which will never happen, which is a very wrong expectation. So these are the words to be avoided. Our policy, per division, seems, misunderstanding. These are the words to be avoided. Finally, the suggestions. Our business process, instead use I or we. I will help you. We will help you to resolve. Our policy, instead of saying our policy, especially the policy, let me help you to do that. Instead of saying department, it's our department, it's somebody else's department when you use, rather use we resolve, which means as an entire organization you are representing. It seems you had. Instead, I'm sorry for your bad experience. It seems means you are dismissive about his experience, not yours. You are misunderstanding. It's a complete blame. Avoid using such phrases itself. I have covered only the first six. I will cover the balance, the remaining six, in my next vlog. Thanks for listening to my vlog. I will come back with my rest of the six words to be avoided in customer communication. If you want to add any more comments, any suggestions, please do drop in the comment section of this video. And please do subscribe to Leaning Towards Six Sigma. I have released a lot of videos on the subject. A very interesting topic I have dealt with from my experience. Please do so. Thank you so much. With my next blog.